Hey guys, it's Renee. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be making some Merry Christmas cookies. I wanted to mention that this is going to be a two-part video, and this is the word Merry. The first thing we're going to be using is our cookie dough recipe. I am using a chocolate cookie dough, and I'm just working with my rolling pin with my spacer bands, and I do have a DIY on this one. This is just going to make your cookies look better because this one is going to keep all the cookies like the same thickness, and they're going to look a lot cuter, and they're going to be done at the same time. So for the letters themselves, I'm going to be using these cookie cutters that I bought at the local store. They are all over the place, and I'm just going to cut all the letters of Merry Christmas. But for my eye, I'm going to just do something different. The point of my eye is going to be actually this kind of leaf cookie cutter that I have, and you're going to find out why once we start working with that one. But I'm just going to cut half my eye, and then I'm just going to place that on the top. So this goes to the oven for about 8 to 12 minutes, but keep an eye on that. For the signs themselves, I'm going to be using Realizing, and I do have a tutorial on this one, and I'm using just Amore colors, by the way. If you want to check them out, they are awesome for this kind of projects, and they are gel food coloring. Just keep working with, you know, liquid food coloring, because those are most likely going to change the consistency of your icing. And all my icing is going to be in the 20 to 25 consistency. So my M, I'm just going to just add a bunch of like lines all over the M. Just go randomly as you want to. Bigger lines, smaller lines, it's up to you. And I'm pretty much going to trace first the outline of my real icing, and then fill the whole thing in, and making sure I don't have any air bubbles. I'm just going to go and use my scribe tool or needle tool. I do have a DIY on this one. It's super useful, this one, by the way. But pretty much I'm going to let each layer of color dry before I move on to the one that is next to it. And as you can see, some of the lines are, you know, bigger, and some of the lines are just thinner. So that's pretty much it for my M, and I'm just going to be working on my E. And this is pretty simple. I'm choosing green and white for this one, but first I'm working on my outline. And then once I have my outline completed, I'm just going to fill the whole thing in with my icing. And I would suggest you to work somewhat fast with this one, because it's not like a round cookie or a square cookie. You have like those lines of the E, and it's a bit more time consuming, this one, because you have to fill those spaces. But not to worry, it's okay, it's fine. I'm just going to work on my air bubbles and things like that with using my scribe tool. Once I have done that, I'm just going to, as quick as I can, be working on my dots. Pretty much just applying dots all over the place. I wanted to go for a kind of polka dot pattern. It's not perfect, but still I think it looks kind of cool. And yeah, the faster you apply those dots, they're going to submerge into your already applied icing. But that's pretty much it for the E. And I'm just going to be moving on my R. My R is pretty much the same for the background of it, and I did use some leftover hats and candy canes from my last project, which I'm going to link below, because I'm going to be using for this one a Santa's hat. But other than that, I'm just going to first work on the outline, then the filling, and then working with my scribe tool to remove all my air bubbles. And I'm going to just let it kind of dry, but not all the way. Once it's starting to get dry, I'm just going to kind of drizzle this red and green real icing. And there is really not right or wrong with this one. You just have to go as you want. And before that dries, I'm just going to add some sprinkles to just kind of add a bit something in there. And I chose kind of Christmassy colors. And really quickly before it dries, I'm just going to add my little Santa's hat, because I thought it looked cuter like this. For my second R, it's going to be pretty much the same. And then once it's dry, I'm just going to be adding my snowman's little hat and the eyes and the nose. The hat is going to be like kind of a 2D-ish kind of thing, working on a square kind of shape. And then on the bottom of that, just adding a line, and that's going to be your hat. It's pretty simple. The eyes are just going to be two black dots, And the gnosis is going to be a triangle, a kind of triangle looking backwards. I know originally it's supposed to be a carrot. Just use your imagination and whatever you feel like doing in there. And that's it for the second R. The next letter is going to be pretty much the same as the first M one in terms of you have to wait for those, you know, lines or codes to dry. But first I'm going to be applying my red kind of lines, but in a diagonal way. Pretty much this is up to you if you want to add them straight. And then once it's dry, I'm just going to go with my white and pretty much doing the same thing, but in the middle of those empty spaces. Shaking a bit my cookies kind of every time I add some realizing. That helps as well to just prevent air bubbles and just helps your realizing go smooth and evenly. And that's pretty much it for the Merry word. So don't forget to tune in next Friday or next weekend for the word Christmas. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe so you can see the other part, and thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you later. Bye guys.